As you know, I'm Jacob.
And I'm Kylie.
I'm having a great morning. So far, have you?
It sure was a great morning until mosquito foggers went through my neighborhood at 4 a.m. Truly annoying.
I think it might rain, so you don't have to worry about those mosquitoes anymore.
Tell us more about that, Trennan.
Good morning, Commons. I'm your weather host, Trennan, and I'm here to tell you the weather for this amazing Wednesday. Today, it will be an average of 66 degrees Fahrenheit, reaching the lowest possible of 58 degrees, with the highest being a nice 75 degrees. It will be raining today, so make sure to wear jackets and keep warm. Now, back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Trennan, for that insightful news info.
Ugh, that pesky rain is back again. I can't wait until winter for that rain to be gone.
Me too. Now for BJ, tell us more about Johnny Appleseed.
Good morning, CCHS. As much as you remember National Celebrity Recognition Day that I mentioned for the very first news broadcast of this year, it's time to talk about another celebrity because it's Johnny Appleseed Day. Johnny Appleseed was born on September 27th, 1774, and that's why every year we celebrate this generous and caring individual of the 18th century. On this day, we honor the man who made apple and pear trees grow across his country. This day is to honor the man, his birth, intellectual ability, wisdom, and enduring story. Before knowing Johnny Appleseed Day, we have to know who Johnny Appleseed is. This name may sound like a children's television show or a nursery rhyme. However, Johnny Appleseed was an American pioneer nurseryman, and he's introduced apple trees to almost all parts of America. So we wouldn't have apple cider or apple pie, not even apple sauce, if it wasn't for Johnny Appleseed. His generous and kind way made him a symbol of the importance of the apple and a key leader in conservation, and we can learn a lot from this guy. You guys have a nice holiday-filled Wednesday because it's also the season to be in the holiday spirit. Jacob and Kylie, back to you.
Thanks, BJ.
Now it's time to get educated about what's going on around here. Take a look at our clothes for the week. If you want to run away with me, I know a galaxy and I can take you for a ride. That we fell into a rhythm where the music don't stop for life. Glitter in the sky, glitter in my eyes, shining just the way you like. If you're feeling like you need a little bit of company, you met me at the perfect time. You want me, I want you, baby, my sugar boo.
Also going on this week is parent-teacher conferences, so plan to bring your parent or guardian in tomorrow for a meet and greet with your teachers. The form to sign up is on our school website.
Due to parent-teacher conferences, all Thursday clubs are canceled.
One more thing. If you ordered a 2023 yearbook, you can pick it up from Mrs. Chafin at the front desk. If you forgot to order but would like a book, you can buy one for $80.
Next up, we have some tips from Miss Arnold.
Mrs. Arnold is part of our I Know I Can team. I Know I Can is here to help you make decisions for after school. Let's hear her advice for this week.
Another week, another I Know I Can update. Juniors can now sign up for the Trades Expo field trip. This is a hands-on field trip. Students will have a chance to actually try out what it would feel like to be in one of the construction trades. So be sure to sign up today in your cohort Google Classroom. We have Malone University coming on October 2nd. Walsh University will be here on the 5th, as well as Ursuline College on the 5th. We'll also have Columbus Police here to do an information session for any students in 11th or 12th grade who are interested in joining a career in law enforcement. So be sure to sign up in your cohort Google Classroom if that sounds like something you'll be interested in. For our I Know I Can college and career tip of the week, it's never too early to start studying for the SAT. Juniors, if you didn't already know, you will be taking that in the spring during the school day. This test is used by colleges to admit students into their schools and also to give scholarship money. So it's always better to have a high test score. And if you study, there's a good chance you will increase your test score. So Khan Academy is a great place to look for study material, and our library as well also has books that you can check out to use to help study for the SAT. Have a great week.
Thank you, Ms. Arnold. We appreciate all you do for Central.
Now we have some HOCO news.
Homecoming is coming. It's only about 83 hours away.
The date is this Saturday from 7 to 10 p.m. in the Aux Gym. The theme is Hollywood red carpet, so dress to impress.
Tickets are on sale for only $10. No tickets will be sold at the door.
Additionally, you can purchase one guest ticket, but you need a guest form which is available at the activity window and the front desk, and it is posted in your Google cohort classroom.
Plus, you have a chance to vote on homecoming royalty right now. This goes for all grade levels. Take a look at some of your senior court members while you are listening. Pull out your Chromebook and go to your Google cohort classroom.
Hey Central, I'm Ava Peoples.
And I'm Alpha Matari.
And we need you to vote for us for homecoming royalty. We're both really good leaders.
I'm the varsity volleyball captain.
I'm the varsity cheer captain.
And we're certified lifeguards. So if you don't vote for us,
we ain't gonna save you.
I'm Jackson.
And I'm Delaney.
And we're the hypest couple at Central Crossing.
Vote for us.
I'm Malik, and you should vote because I'm a good person, you know, nice to everybody. I'm involved in extracurriculars and stuff like that, like football, track. I'm in the athletic leadership committee and all that, you know, yeah.
My name is Zoe Bowman. You should vote for me because why not?
So now it's time to vote. All you need to do is go to your Google cohort classroom and vote for two seniors. And remember, gender does not matter. Simply vote for two seniors. Voting will close today at 3:30.
Homecoming is a school tradition that you will remember. I promise you will forget about many things that occur in the classroom. They're still important though. But you will remember homecoming. And it's okay to just come with a bunch of friends or even two or three friends. Just go for a quick dinner, laugh, dance, and enjoy being you.
To celebrate homecoming, we have Spirit Week this week. Today is favorite holiday, but of course, I don't truly have a favorite holiday. There's too many to pick from.
Personally, mine is Christmas. I just enjoy the feeling of being warm while watching some Home Alone and Elf with the hot chocolate.
Ooh. Tomorrow is Ken and Barbie. So get out your pink, get out your neon, get out your sparkles, and have some fun with your fit. Ken's, consider slicking back your hair, and Barbie's, rock that ponytail.
Then, Friday is Comet Gear. I better see everyone in all blue.
Comets, get dressed in your best fits for Spirit Week.
Now, it's time to head over to Mikey and Tim for some sport news.
Hey, sporters.
Hey, Timberly.
Hey, Mikey.
Are you ready for some sports today?
I'm so ready.
So let's get into some result news.
Our girls' golf team is finishing up their second year of existence here at CCHS. Our girls have recorded their best scores for 9 holes in their last 2 competitions. Take a look.
Gretchen Smink, and Carly Carter, who are improving with every meet.
They will start their postseason competition on Tuesday, October 3rd at Oak Haven Golf Club.
The CCHS girls golf team is looking for more golfers to join us next season. It is a great way to get involved, meet new friends, and enjoy the outdoors.
And we also have some congrats for our volleyballers.
The Lady Comets swept Groveport on the road. Varsity improved to 11-5 on the season. Good job, Lady Comets. Volleyball is back in action at home on Thursday for a big rematch against Lancaster. Come out and support.
Now, let's see what's happening in conditioning news.
Winter sports is currently conditioning, including the swim team, the basketball team, gymnastics, and wrestling.
Spring sports are also getting started, including softball, baseball, and track and field.
You can get the details from the TVs in the cafeteria.
Now let's see what's happening tonight.
Varsity golf is playing away at Franklin Heights at noon. Good luck, athletes, and you guys got this.
Then tomorrow we have
girls freshman JV and varsity volleyball at home against Lancaster. Freshman and JV at 5:30 and varsity at 7.
Boys JV and varsity soccer are away at Olentangy. JV at 5:30, varsity at 7:15.
Girls varsity soccer is at home against Cristo Rey Columbus at 7:15.
And Comets, it's only one day away.
What is?
Football Friday night!
We're taking on Pick Central at home at 7 o'clock. It's our homecoming game, so come out and go bonkers in the student section. It's also blue out, so rock out that Comet blue.
Also, before the game, it's tailgate time, Comets. Before the football game on Friday, there'll be a tailgate outside the stadium. It starts at 5:30, there'll be games, music, and food, so come out and have a good time before the homecoming game.
But that's all the Sportalicious, Sportastic sports info that we have to spit at you today.
I hope you have a blissful day, Comets.
Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, sporters.
Okay, Central, that's enough yapping for today. I hope you have a good day and drink loads of water.
Bye.